हेलो एवरीवन, तो वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समग्रह निर्विघ्नं कुरुमे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देव महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। सो मो जीवन जितेक शिक्षक प्राइमरी स्कूल ठू आरंभ करके मोर कॉलेज पर्यंत प्रोफेशनल कॉलेज पर्यंत समस्त मोर सादर प्रणाम, कहीं से मत न शिखेगले हम तो आज पर्यटन पहुँची पार ना। सो समस्त को प्रणाम। वीडियो में जनरली इंग्लिश और हिंदी यूज करी जोद्वारा कि इंडिया समस्ते ये विषय जापर जिन बुझीपर। ओके नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द टेक्निक, ओनली टेक्निक बट ओवेरियो हिस्टेरेक्टोमी। एज द नेम ओवेरियो मीन्स ओवरी, हिस्टेर इन यूटरस, एक्टोमी इज सर्जिकल एक्सिशन और सर्जिकल रिमूवल, यू कैन से सर्जिकल एक्सिशन। एनी वर्ड विथ एक्टोमी मीन सर्जिकल एक्सिशन। मास्टेक्टोमी इज रिमूवल ऑफ मामरी टिश्यू, स्प्लीनेक्टोमी इज रिमूवल ऑफ स्प्लीन। नाउ दीज आर द कंडीशंस इन व्हिच ओवेरियन हिस्टेरेक्टोमी इज रेडिकल ट्रीटमेंट और ऑप्शनल ट्रीटमेंट। ओवेरियन ट्यूमर, यूटेराइन ट्यूमर, मामरी ट्यूमर, बायोमेट्रल, सी सेक्शन। समटाइम्स यू विल गेट केसेस इन व्हिच द सी सेक्शन इज डिलेड, तो ड्यूरिंग सी सेक्शन सम मिस हैपनिंग मे बी देयर, सो टू सेव द एनिमल्स लाइफ यू कैन गो फॉर ओवरी हिस्टेरेक्टोमी। देन द नॉर्मल, दिस इज नॉर्मल केस, दीज आर पैथोलॉजिकल केसेस, दिस इज फैमिली प्लानिंग ऑपरेशन। बिफोर गोइंग टू द टेक्निक फर्स्ट वी शुड नो सम एनाटॉमी। ओके now you know this is vagina, this cervix, uterine body, uterine wall, this blue color is ovarian bursa, and then the middle, the red one is ovary. This is suspensory ligament which joins ovary to the last rib. Then this is proper ligament or ligament proper between the ovary and the uterus. This is ovarian pedicle which contains the ovarian artery which is the direct branch of aorta. I have used this curvature because you know the animal is sleeping in ventrodorsal. The dorsal, ventral side is upward, the dorsal side is into the blackboard. Okay, so the ovarian artery will arise from aorta, then it will go like this, okay, to the ovaries like this. That is why I have given slight curvature to understand this. Next, this is also known as ovarian pedicle. This green color is broad ligament. Okay. Now some anatomical positions. This is left side because the animal is in ventrodorsal position. This is right side. This is navel. And you know, away from the medial is lateral, middle is medial. Okay. So you know all the anatomy now. This is lateral side. Okay. This is ventrodorsal. This lateral. You are standing on the right side of the animal. You will see from lateral angle. It will look like this. Okay. Next, we will go. The main focus of this lecture is how to rupture this suspensory ligament. Okay. This ligament you have to rupture very carefully. So now you are given the incision. I will talk about incision later. Okay. You have given the incision. You have found the uterus and also ovary. But the ovary won't form outside the incision line if you do not rupture the suspensory ligament. Okay, but you can possibly take out the ovary, but it is not a proper procedure. And sometimes, remember this: the pulling of suspensory ligament causes pain. Okay, if the animal is in deep plane or a mild surgical plane even, the animal might try to get out because of continuous pain. But if you rupture this, then also it becomes easy to ligate this ovarian pedicle, and also the pain will be minimal, and the animal won't get up that much easily. And in OT you might see, if you will pull the suspensory ligament, animal produces sound if the animal is not in surgical plane. And in field condition, the surgical, achieving the surgical plane is really difficult because we know we do not have major diagnostic procedures or major equipmental we generally prefer not so deep plane surgical plane but light surgical plane. Okay. So you need to rupture this suspensory ligament. Now, how to rupture it? Remember, this is proper ligament. Suppose this is right side. I have to break this right suspensory ligament. Okay. What I will do? I will hold the proper ligament here. Okay. And I will pull towards caudal side. Here. In caudal direction. Okay. I will pull this in caudal direction. Suspensory ligament will be tensed. Okay. Now with my left hand, I will slide my hand towards the rib. This is a very thick band, okay? You can clearly identify the thick ligament, okay? And this is just a membrane, okay? You can, if you put your hand there, you can easily feel which one is the ligament and which one is the broad ligament, okay? Suspensory ligament and broad ligament. I will pull this in collar side. Then I will move my hand few centimeters. Then after some, because the ovarian pedicle which contains the ovarian arteries, actually the direct branch of aorta, the blood pressure is very very high. Okay, you do not want to disturb, you won't want to disturb this ovarian pedicle. Once this one is ruptured, the bleeding will be much faster and the condition will be worse. Okay, so I am holding this here. I will move my index finger few centimeters away. Okay, now I will put pressure lateral to medial, okay, not medial to lateral, because if you put pressure medial to lateral, after some time the wall comes, okay, the abdominal wall, it won't get ruptured easily. I will show you. Now I have pulled the proper ligament caudally and now I am putting pressure. This will get bent, nice bent. At a point of time, it will rupture. Okay. This will rupture. Once this ruptures, this ligation becomes much more easier and see lateral view. You see, this is very much flexible, the ovarian pedicle. It will easily come out of incision and you can ligate this one very, very easily. Okay. So this one, remember, lateral to medial, the suspensory ligament, the proper ligament towards the caudal direction. Same happens with the left suspensory ligament. In left, you have to hold this in your left hand, move your finger, index finger, along the suspensory ligament, few centimeters, then you have to put, here this one is lateral, this one is medial, so you have to put pressure like this, after some time, will be like this, after some time it will rupture. Okay. So this is the technique to rupture the suspensory ligament. Remember, in this portion blood ligament, there are no major blood vessels. Okay, these are simply membrane, a transparent membrane. Okay. You do not have to worry about anything happen or any bleeding will be there. There will not be any bleeding. You simply have to rupture the suspensory ligament. Now the technique. Okay. After you rupture the suspensory ligament, now the technique is very, very easy. First, this view is better to understand than this. Okay. First, you put a hemostat here. Okay. This is a hemostat or which you call back and forth in the ligament, on the ligament proper. Okay. You cycle it with an assistant or you can do it manually. When you get 2-3 cases or 3-4 cases, then you will know how to lift with using your rest fingers and ligate in this ovarian pedicle with the rest of the fingers. Okay. So you have to put artery pressure here. Tell your assistant to lift this proper ligament with the help of this artery. When you lift this, it will come out of the incision. You ligate this suspensory ligament along with the ovarian pedicle with 0.5 mm apart, two ligation,
Okay.
Because same thing. This is the direct branch of abdominal aorta. So it requires a fixed and very proper ligation. Okay. So you ligate twice. After ligation, you put a hemostat here. Okay. And then the hemostat, between the hemostat and the most ventral ligation, remember this is ventral side, okay, this is dorsal side, most ventral ligation, this should be also 0.5 mm apart, okay, because if you will put your hemostat just after the ligation, you know hemostat will cause crushing of tissue. When you finally will be checking by holding the dorsal most ligation, there is a chance that this ligation might slip. Okay, there might be bleeding. So you have to. This one is also 0.5 mm apart. This is also 0.5 mm. Then you simply cut this with a blade or scissor. Now ovary has been removed. Okay, from its blood supply, nerve supply, everything. Now comes the uterine cord. You see, this is a broad ligament. Okay, the red color here, this one, these are blood supplies. We will find the uterine crest very close to the uterus, near here. Okay. Do not disturb this crest. You make a tear here, then here, near the uterine body. Two tears. Now you move these tears close so that the broad ligament will be closed. How this looks like this. Okay. That means you should simply move these tears closer so that the broad ligament will be bounced. Okay. Now put here one hemostat. Okay. Simply rupture this one. Now you see the uterine horn is separate. After uterine horn, you have to ligate same procedure for the, this one is the right side, same procedure for the left ovary, left suspensive ligament and the left uterine horn. Next you have to ligate the uterine body. Always ligate the uterine body as close as to surface, because there are been cases in which if you leave some uterine body, it may result in strong pyometra. So here you put two ligations as close as to surface. This is 0.5 mm apart. Okay. Now put a hemostat here. Between this, the last ligation and the hemostat, also keep some distance, 0.5 mm apart. Now, you simply using BP blade or scissor cut here. You see, the whole system has been isolated. From here to ovary, uterine horn, then uterine bone. Now, the whole system, that is the reproductive system, can be taken out from the body. Okay. You have understood the technique. Important is rupturing the suspensory ligament. Remember, the force on suspensory ligament is lateral to medial, and the proper ligament is towards caudal side. Do not pull the proper ligament what is the ventral. Do not put the problem enter, let it away from the body. What will happen? Simply this ovarian pedicle will rupture. Okay. Once this one rupture, I told you, this is a direct branch of aorta. There will be very, 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 very high bleeding. Okay. So do not disturb the ovarian pedicle. Now we have understood the technique, also how to rupture the suspension ligament. Now I will tell you about some incisions. Okay. Now I will tell you what is the difference between dog and cat. Over age children, there are some differences. You see, in cat, this proper ligament, okay, this is very much fragile. In cat, this one is fragile in cat. So, while pulling the proper ligament, be very, very, very gentle. But God is the Almighty. He knows that this one is weak. So, in case of cat, it is very easy to find the ovary and suspensive ligament. Even if you do not have to rupture the suspensive ligament because it is very, very loose, it will easily come out of the incision, you can lie it. Okay? In case of cat, handling the cervix is different. In cat, it is very difficult to find cervix. In case of dog, very difficult to find the ovary. Okay? So, in case of cat, you know there is no problem in ligating the uterine incisors because they are very easy to ligate. So in case of cat, you have to keep two finger incision from the navel. From the navel, you measure two finger, then you have to give the incision. In case of dog, it's same. That is, you may ask that why two fingers in dog, one finger in cat, because the size is less. The reason is here. Because you keep two finger in dog, you get ovary. But in cat, the cervix is difficult to find. So we keep two fingers so that we can reach the cervix in better. Now, I will tell you something about the incision. So, here is navel. In some animal, you may not find the navel location. So the guideline is the last limb. Okay, you have to with your thumb after the last limb with your index, point touches the when the point touches is the navel. Okay, so you have to measure two fingers, then give incision. Incision is 4 inches long. You see, if they are going for family planning operation, surgeons prefer 1 inch or 2 inch incisions. Because the ovarian vessels will not be engorged or that much thick. They will be thin and also the uterus will be thread-like or maybe your little finger thick. Okay? So thin. But in rest of the cases, you do not know the uterus size because in field, you do not have ultrasonography. Or X-ray, in some distributed patterns you can find X-ray, but not in all cases. So it is better to give adequate incision so that you can work better. Give 4 inch long incision or you can extend up to 5 inch, no problem. Okay. When you give incision, after you separate the skin, you will find like this. Okay. Below the skin, you will find the subcutaneous fat. Now, trim the subcutaneous fat using scissors. You have trimmed now the subcutaneous fat. Now, you will find the linea alba. Okay? Linea alba is a thin white line. Okay? The linea alba. How to recognize the linea alba? First I told you, this is a thin white line. If you still are confused, you can find the directions of muscles. It will be like this. It's like, you know, plant pinna. Okay, so just like this. The opposite directions muscles will be joining at that point. Okay, this is the linea alba. Next, after finding linea alba, with your thumb portion, lift the linea alba. Okay, you have lifted the linea alba using BP blade. Okay, make a star incision. Remember, while making the star incision, the sharp side should be away from the body because if you are giving a star incision with the sharp end towards the body, then you may injure some internal organs. So it is better to give incision stab incision with sharp end towards you or away from the body. After giving the stab incision, use your thumb person. Okay. With thumb person, use your thumb person. You can see in my video. Okay. Using thumb person, you have to extend the incision. Remember, the muscle incision should be 1 inch less than the skin incision because you have to suture the muscles. Imagine the situation: your incision is 4 inch long and muscle is 6 inch long. So how will you suture it? There will be a problem. You have to pull the skin towards this side, then you have to suture this end, then you have to pull this end. So avoid any complications. Always keep the muscle incisions 1 inch less than the skin incision. So this is your skin incision and this is your muscle incision. Okay. Now finding the uterus. You see in camel running, there is an instrument which is called an ovarian hook by which you can find the uterus. Okay. But if you do not have uterus ovarian hook, so how to find? Or a uterine hook? So remember, the bladder is here. Okay. This is bladder. You know the bladder opens into the vagina. So bladder dorsal to the bladder. Remember, this is ventral side. Towards the blackboard is dorsal side. Okay. So towards the dorsal side of the bladder lies the cervix. Okay. By finding the cervix, you can find the uterus. But in case of C-section or biomedical, the uterus is very highly engorged. You can find the uterus very easy. Okay. And remember, you have to distinguish between the uterus and the intestine. You know the anatomy. By anatomy, you know which one is uterus, which one is intestine. Okay. So after that, suppose you have found the uterus and you have exteriorized. Suppose this one is right side uterus. Okay. You have exteriorized the right side uterus. Now you will find here the ovary. The ovary will not come beyond the incision point, okay, because of suspensory ligament. So you have to rupture the suspensory ligament. Remember, you have to hold the proper ligament and pull it to a caudal direction. Then you insert your finger, index finger, along the suspensory ligament, few centimeters. After that, you apply the force from lateral to medial. Okay. When you will apply, this will get ruptured. After the rupture, you can easily, the uterus and the ovary will come out easily, okay, along with the ovarian bed. Okay. So you have to put a hemostat here, okay, the proper ligament. Then you have to ligate twice, that is double ligation. Ligate here, then 0.5 mm apart. Okay, next you will have to put the hemostat 0.5 mm bend from the ventral ligation. This one is dorsal ligation, the ventral ligation. You have to put the hemostat, then keeping 0.5 mm tissue, you have to cut it. Okay, now ovary is separated. Now I have told how to separate the uterine body. Remember, you make a window here, then at the cervical point or uterine body, then so now you have to make this clear. So you have to make a window here, next window you have uterine body. Okay. You have to separate the broad ligament. Now uterine horn is it does the same thing with the left ovary, left uterine horn. After that you have to ligate the cervix. Okay. Then excise the whole the reproduction system out. Okay. After removing uterine, the uterus and ovary. This is skin incision. This is muscle incision. Now, close the muscle incision with the observable suture. Outdated now, but in the interior of the body, I mean, the R1 suture may find catgut or polyclactin 910, which is more popular in the name of Bicrylo. Bicrylo is a brand name. Bicrylo or PDS, polydactylin. Now, the pattern of suturing. If you are seeing the animal is too heavy or too fatty or beyond 35 kg or 40 kg weight, always put horizontal mattress. Okay. Because the horizontal mattress is a tension suture. It will hold much more tension than other sutures. Otherwise, if you are finding the animal weight 25 kg or 30 kg, you can use the simple continuous. Okay. Simple continuous. In some of the YouTube videos, you will find that they use simple interrupted pattern of sutures. Okay, they are basically your family plan where the incision is 1 to 2 inch or below 1 inch. Okay, so in that case, simple interrupted is preferred. But in that video, you also find they use monofilament PDS. Okay, this is one of the strongest sutures. Okay. So in that case, it is fine. But in field condition. People can't afford actually PDS, okay. Some people might can afford the polylactin and most of them can afford the catgut. So in cat, if you are using catgut, always prefer the horizontal mattress or simple continuous. After the closure of muscle, okay, after muscle closure, you have to close the subcutaneous. This is muscle closed. Muscle closed. Now the subcutaneous tissue, also known as subcut suture. The subcut suture is nothing but a simple continuous type suture. Okay. You have to start at one end, then up to the next end. After that, the skin sutures. You see, skin suture always, I would say always in field, use horizontal mattress. Okay. For skin. Skin always use horizontal mattress. And this is non-absorbable. With non-absorbable suture, always try to use nylon, okay, or polyamide. The name is actually polyamide, the brand name is nylon. Nylon or rulon, etc. etc. When I will teach about sutures, I will tell about they come with some certain specific type of needles, so the reverse cutting needle, potting needle, round needle. Okay. And in case of skin, always use reverse cutting needle. Reverse cutting needle is very, very good. Okay. You can finish the skin suture in 1 to 2 minutes. If they are using some round body needle, it may take longer to do. So, you have now under skin closure. After the skin closure, you apply some bandage with tape. And most of the time, animal will remove bandage after recovery. You do not have to worry. Just tell the owner to apply some antiseptic ointments twice daily up to 6-7 days. After 6-7 days, you can see good healing. Okay, the sutures will be removed. Actually, through guideline, this will be removed after 10 days. Okay, because in field condition, the care for the wound actually not that good. In urban population, you will find very good care for the wounds by the owners. But when you go to the little semi-urban or rural area, they don't know much about this. Whatever you will tell, they will simply job, but sometimes they may not care for that. So you take 10 days or 12 days maximum, then remove the sutures.
Okay.
This is all about ovarian hysterectomy. You have understood all the concepts as the anatomy, then how to remove the uterus and ovary, and then next the surgical techniques, the suture techniques. After this, if you have any doubt, please comment. I will try my best to reply your comments when I am free, but do comment. Thank you very, very much. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. In next class, I will try to cover the anesthesia. I will only cover the protocols that can be used in field anesthesia. I will not go to the cutar benzodiazepines or cutar phenothiazine group, alpha 2 agonist. I am not going to the pharmacology. I will only describe what are the protocols and which parameters you should take care of, or which signs should be you are aware of, and specifically how to maintain the anesthesia, and which signs you will see so that you can give a bolus administration. Okay. I will cover all that in my next class. Thank you very much. Bye bye.